After requests on my last Illustrator pen tool tricks and tips video, today I have a more in-depth Illustrator pen tool tricks video brought to you by Satori Graphics. You can move to the timestamp in the corner to skip the intro. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. I quickly want to remind you guys that if you are subscribed to my channel, click the bell icon so you stay updated to every single video that I upload. I know that some people never find my videos in their newsfeed. Anyway, let's jump into today's pen tool tricks tutorial in Illustrator. The first Illustrator pen tool trick is starting off fairly simple, and that is utilizing the shift key. First of all, you can access the pen tool by pressing P on your keyboard, or you can find it here. If you click once on the canvas in Illustrator with the pen tool, you can hold down shift and you will find that you make the next point perfectly straight from the first. Also at 45 degrees and also at 90 degrees. You can move around in a 360 degree circle, making a point at every 45 degree angle. We're going to be looking at how to use the shift key for digital typography later in the tutorial. If we make an anchor point with the pen tool, we can make a curved line like so. If we then hold down shift with the curved line, the Bezier handles can follow the 45 and 90 degree angle orientation as before. You can see the handles sticking and snapping into 45 and 90 degree positions as I move the cursor with the shift held down. The next Illustrator pen tool trick involves the Alt Option key. If we make an anchor point and then a curved line, we can hold down the Alt Option key to edit the handles independently. An important tip to note is that if you hold down Alt and then Shift, the handle will follow the 45 and 90 degree rule as before. I'm going to show you why that's important next. Here, I have a calligraphy style letter locked down as a template to draw around. You can press Ctrl or Command R to open up the rulers, and then we need to use vertical and horizontal guides to place just where the letter touches. When we use the pen tool, we can use the tricks and techniques that we've just covered at 90 degrees angles, but never use 45 degrees for typography. I will show you what I mean now. So carefully place your guides just touching the letter at 90 degree angles. With the pen tool, click, but with Alt and Shift held down, and then drag out a handle in the direction that you want to head. Never bring the handle past the opposing guide. So on this point here, I will not move it past the guide on the right. You now have a curved line to which you can move to the next point. Hold down shift and make a click and drag to make the handles, keeping things at 90 degrees angles the entire time. We can use Alt to adjust the handle curves, taking our time to be precise with everything. Shift will help keep things level also. From the new point, repeat the process of holding down Alt and Shift together and then drag out a handle, and then make the new point. If you carry on with this technique carefully, you'll be able to draw out perfectly smooth and crisp lines using the pen tool in Illustrator. It does take some time to get used to, but this is the most methodical and best way to work with the pen tool when creating lines in Illustrator, especially for typography such as this. As you can see, I used the pen tool tricks and techniques we discussed at the very start of the video. Practice this technique and master the pen tool with typography. We all know that you can edit anchor points with the direct selection tool. By the way, if you press A on your keyboard, you can access the direct selection tool. But what if we're in the middle of making a path with a pen tool? This next Illustrator pen tool trick will allow you to access the direct selection tool without clicking off of the path or the pen tool. Simply hold down the command key on a Mac or the control key on Windows, and you'll be able to access the direct selection tool. Now you can edit the path and continue drawing without changing tools in the tool panel. The next Illustrator pen tool trick involves the spacebar key on your keyboard. Again, if you are drawing a path and you click to make a new anchor point, you can hold down the spacebar and you will be able to change the position of the anchor point. This can be helpful if you make a mistake or if you're unsure of where to place the next point. Another subtle but effective use of the spacebar when using the Illustrator pen tool is that if you hold it down, it will allow you to navigate around the screen with ease, all whilst drawing with the pen tool. Maybe you need to draw off of the screen, and instead of clicking off the path, just hold down the spacebar and click and drag like so. This next pen tool trick is activated for those who have Illustrator CC. If we draw a path with the pen tool and then take the direct selection tool, we will find that the white circles appear in the corners of the shape. We can then edit the shape like so. And if we highlight more than one corner or section, we can adjust them simultaneously. This pen tool trick will really help you when making shapes for logo designs, for example. The last pen tool trick before the Satori bonus tip of the day is about adding and removing anchor points on the path quickly. If you make a path using the Illustrator pen tool and then hover the cursor over the anchor point, you will notice a minus icon appear. If you then click, this will remove the anchor point. Also, if we hover over the path itself with no anchor points in place, we can then add an anchor point. We can then go ahead and edit the anchor points like so. If you come over to the pen tool in the tool panel, you will see that the shortcuts for these functions are here. The Satori bonus tip of the day is practice. Practice the pen tool and then master it. There's a link in the description below for a game that uses the same functions and features of the Illustrator pen tool. And you can play through the levels with increasing difficulty. This is a fun way to improve your knowledge and your skills with the pen tool. Also, you can Google search pen tool practice and take a look at the images. You will find heaps of templates for you to try and draw around. So download a few of these and then try your skills on them. Keep practicing because practice does make perfect. So there were my 8 Illustrator pen tool tricks. What did you think of today's video? Let me know in the comment section below and drop a like on your way out. Share my content to others if you really do find it useful. And remember to subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content, just like this video here. Make sure you have a great day and until next time, design your future today. Peace.